And welcome back. The average wedding can run nearly $30,000, and expensive wedding dresses can take a big chunk out of that budget. A local woman entered a cheap, chic wedding dress contest and made the entire gown out of northern toilet paper. That's right. Ashley, how do you say your last name, Ashley?
Ulissini. Yeah,
Ulissini. You're the first Ulissini I've ever met. She's a finalist in the 13th annual Cheap Chic Weddings Contest sponsored by Quilted Northern, and she's here to talk about her designs and show us some stuff as well. Now, you are local. You're from here, right?
Well, I originally grew up in Oregon, but I've been here for about 12 years now.
Okay, so you live in Manchester?
Yeah. Yes.
You live in Manchester. Yeah. So the first question I'm sure that people want to know is, how in the world did you come to get involved in something like that?
Yeah, well, I had seen it on an ad on Facebook like last year. Uh-huh. Last year was my first time entering, so that's kind of how I went about it. I had heard about it before, but last year was my first time entering, so yeah.
Wow. So, okay, the design of this dress, what goes into all of that?
A lot. So you can only use Quilted Northern toilet paper. They were the sponsor this year. Any kind of tape, any kind of glue, and needle and thread sewing machine.
So, wow, yeah, so we have some pictures of that, like, that's amazing.
Oh
my gosh.
You. The now, pictures aren't too great, yeah.
Now, are you a designer, like, on your own, aside from this, or?
Right now, it's a hobby. I'm trying to get back into it, but, yeah, hopefully,
okay.
I'd love to do that. Yeah?
Now, my question to you is, and I'm sure maybe a lot of viewers may be thinking this question, are you concerned about water getting on this dress?
I know,
and what can happen with that?
That's what everyone says. Yeah, I mean, it will dampen a little bit, so you have to be careful, but there's, you know, lots of tape and glue on there, but yeah, definitely don't want to get it wet.
Okay, you have some stuff to show us really quickly?
Yeah, so this is just a sample. I don't have the dress with me because it's in New York.
They have it?
Yeah, they have it. But this is just a sample. I did a bunch of roses and cut out leaves and everything.
So. You know, it's pretty sturdy feeling, actually.
Yeah, it is, with glue and obviously tape and everything. Yeah.
Wow. So do you do? You just kind of prepare each piece and then you put it, you stack it on top? Because, like, it doesn't feel like...
Oh, toilet paper.
It feels like paper mache or something
like
that.
Yeah, that's basically what you do. So I put Elmer's glue with a little water and then more Elmer's glue and water on the top. And then I put athletic tape on the back. So everything's kind of
like make it stay.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
Yeah.
So how long did it take for you to make your dress?
I know. I didn't count the hours, actually, but about 3 months altogether.
About 3 months?
Yeah.
Wow. So at the end, you're in the top 10 of this competition, right?
Yes.
So in the end, let's say you won, because,
oh,
you know, she's got skills, people. What do you win?
The winner wins $10,000, and also their dress is featured in a Ripley's Believe It or Not museum, which is one of the sponsors. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
So I guess at this point, so what's next for you? So the competition, it goes from?
Yeah.
Yeah. So people can still vote for you?
Yeah, there's a fan favorite. It's not actually for the grand prize winner, but a fan favorite. You can go to tpdresscontest.com and vote for your fan favorite. Obviously, be very grateful for any votes.
Okay,
yeah.
Very cool. Okay, let's get one more shot. Can we put her picture of her dress up one more time? That is just so awesome.
Oh, thank you.
All right, Ashley, thank you very much for joining us today.
That's
pretty awesome. Then I'll send it back over to you.
All right, we're coming right back. But